总给你正会。
哟，山呀，You see, that's what you want. That's what you want. They're jumping about. That's what young people's pop music is supposed to be. Too many bands at Glastonbury giving it this. Hello, Glastonbury. How are you doing? You don't want any of that. You want a bit of willful destruction on stage. That's what rock and roll
will.
Come on, Arkin. Let's show my... Wait. Whoa. That's what you want. Beastie Boys. Top act. Top tackle. No bobbins. Right, a bit earlier on, Katie talked to the Beastie Boys in our luxury bus. And, let's have a look at what they were talking about.
Where do you go?
I'm hosting just a little bit of a soiree on the lower deck here with the Beastie Boys. And we are liking it. We're just all sitting in a line on something that isn't normally used as a studio. Have you ever been on a London double-decker bus?
Yes.
Kind of weird.
I used to rock the outfits like the guy in the back.
The conductor.
I used to rock the outfit so I could get on the bus for free.
Mm-mm.
Sneaky. Sneaky stop.
It's a number four.
It is a number four, but it is kind of like a number four bus in a certain sort of way. Have you ever been on the kind of buses where, this isn't one of them, but the kind where you almost fall off the back in order to get off, they have no door?
Yeah.
And you take your life in your hands?
Been on those.
Yep. Got one of those. I put a special modified engine in the front, does 0-60 in only 6.7 seconds.
You have to hold on to the pole, right?
You have to hold on to the pole, but sometimes that pole is slick.
I used to put Vaseline on the pole so people could slip.
Yep.
You are some kind of mischief maker. I can tell you what. Now, I was watching your show a little while ago, and it was raining, but people were still staying with you guys because you were rocking that field. It wasn't a house, it was a field. Is this the first time you've ever played in a field?
We done some special
stuff. You used to play shortstop in the field.
Shortstop and first base.
We used to play a couple of bonds back in the day.
We'll rock the pool, rock the pond.
Rock the pond and the ocean. Yeah. But is this the first time you've been at Glastonbury? This is what I'm driving at.
Yes. First time the band has ever been here.
Impressions?
Glastonbury.
We should probably warn, most of the folks here to stay away from the brown acid.
Right, yeah. Right.
There's a bad
and also the brown cider.
And do you have any sort of tips if somebody gets in a bad way with some of the comestibles?
Just stay cool.
And the rain is a good thing. The rain is your friend.
The rain
keeps
is beautiful.
Green. It was a nice break in our set. Like when it started raining, it started
I'm afraid
cheering.
That the rain flattened my hair at that stage. I was sporting a very nice bouffant, and it just collapsed.
I'm having a bad hair day myself.
Yeah, my bouffant just fell right off.
Well, what's a good hair day for you?
Well, actually, my hair is freshly shorn right now.
Well, that's beautiful. That's wonderful.
I usually have the lovely ginger hair, but today...
You're featuring a different look. And have you seen anybody that you like, that impresses you, that inspires you on any of the other stages?
I saw a guy with a Jesus t-shirt lying down, passed out, with Mickey Mouse ears and a big nose like this.
The court jester.
With a sword.
Yeah, with a sword. Seen him.
Yeah.
He inspired me.
And have you seen a lot of Jesus lookalikes happening, lots of loincloth action.
I was just thinking, I was walking through all these people, going to one stage and walking back, and I was thinking, all these people are, going here, going there, and, I realized Jesus himself could walk right through everybody, and no one would really actually
You seen the guy? The guy on the American soccer team that's a crusty? We got a crusty on our team.
The white guy
with the goatee and shit.
Oh, I did see that. He was like horn blowing a little bit.
In a way.
Yeah.
In a way. This place is chock full of crusties. And are you planning to attend any of these little symposiums? They have things where you get in touch with your inner self and you learn how to make... You learn how to make prehistoric shoes. Apparently they found...
We don't need to do that.
Oh, why? Because you're wearing them.
No, because our friend, Keyboard Money Mark, can make shoes out of cardboard.
You can make them out of wood.
Yeah.
But why would you want to make shoes out of wood?
Well, it's a Dutch tradition. It's an old Dutch crusty tradition. And, I think that people are giving the crusties too hard a time. Because we're all crusties in our own special way.
Yeah.
The other thing that's special about Mark is he also has this technique where he can go to, Montgomery Ward or, a place where you can buy a very cheap pair of shoes or even a thrift store, and he converts them into open-air sandals for the hot weather. Cuts open the front, does a few modifications.
Sounds very innovative.
He's
so is this something
innovative.
That you could advise maybe for a festival look?
Yeah. It's a little warm. Your toes are feeling boxed in. Yeah. Feet are sweating. Yeah. Just cut those puppies open.
And bring a lot of clothes and a pair of scissors, and you'll be straight.
I've noticed that you're sporting some duds here. This is your company, is it not? X Large.
A partner in the company.
And do you go home like after events like these and start beavering away with new ideas for designs? You get at your drawing board.
Yeah, we got our crusty line coming out.
Crusty line coming out
very soon. Got mudware. Mm. That's going to be big.
Have a nice day, gear.
You know.
And what about the fact
you gotta figure out how many people are here?
I'm gonna ask you a very serious musical question.
I have one question. How many people are here?
Let's go to 42nd Street.
I don't know. You've gone back to your hardcore sort of beginnings. I've noticed you spring quite significantly from one kind of hip hop mode to this hardcore punk rock thing, and you just kind of boing around in people's heads. You think it's too much for people to take in?
Hard to please.
We boing around.
You like
nothing
to boing.
Wrong with boinging.
No.
Good gig here of boinging.
Well, I just don't know what to say about that. I mean, because the thing is that you were just out there. You were doing, the crowd was didn't know whether to stand up or sit down, come or go. You're not worried about sort of tailoring your stuff to the audience.
Tonight it was having a good time to me.
Yeah, I think it actually worked out. Like, you know,
we're smoothed out on the R&B tip.
Smooth it out when we had to.
And
got into
have
the mellow stuff when, you know, after the rain
and so
started.
So what's left for you at Glastonbury? Are you going to stay here for the rest of the time? What are you going to do? What are you going to see?
Well, I popped me tent.
We got four boys in a tent?
We got a gig in Spain tomorrow night.
All right, so you're not going to be hanging around.
We'd love to.
Well,
I mean, we did all have our tents and we were ready, but this thing popped up in Spain and we're out
skiing. We pop our tents down there.
Well, these Beastie Boys are going to be popping off pretty soon with their tents in Spain. Thanks very much for coming on my lower deck.
Thank you for having us.